It's like GPS for your life. The Sky Vibe Show. So you found us. Astrology. The Sky Vibe. Hi, I'm Judy. Judi Diamond. And over there next to me is my very good friend and professional astrologist, Thomas Miller. Hi, Thomas.
Voila, Judy.
I'm really excited about this, that we're finally getting this off the ground.
Well, we had to wait. You know, most people today are, no, don't wait. Put it together now. Get a team together and get this out the door. But we had to wait. We had to put the brakes on and wait until Mercury got out of retrograde.
That's right. And why astrology? Because astrology is like, to me, a map. When you go somewhere, use your GPS to get directions on how to go there. That's kind of how I like to think of astrology.
You know, astrology has such a bad rap with so many people who don't understand it. They don't take the time to look into it to really understand what astrology is all about. I'll just give you one example. There's something called the ecliptic line. It goes around the Earth. See, from astrology's perspective, the Earth is at the center. It's geocentric. We know that's not how it is in space, but it is in astrology. What do you see the sun do every day? It rises in the east and moves across to the west. So that's the perspective that we look at astrology through. Well, there's this great big imaginary circle that goes around the Earth called the ecliptic. And get this, now all of the planets in our solar system, from Mercury, which is closest to the sun, all the way out to Pluto, which is 3.3 billion miles away from Earth, even including our own moon, all perfectly align along that ecliptic line. It's miraculous. And all astrology is just a study of what all that means in our lives.
And you have a place in it. How did that happen? I think it's all meant to be. And astrology is also just about every religion. It's in science. You will have backed up research that we talk about a full moon and how it affects us. If you think about it, we are part of it. We were coming from dust and material and the planet. So we're all connected.
Well, the idea of astrology is that each one of those planets along that great big circle represents a compartment or a pocket of our lives. And all astrology is the study of where they are on that circle and how they relate to each other, which you look at through geometry, mathematics, but it's just angles. Think about a circle. You can have two planets at the same point on the circle. Let's say up at 12 o'clock. That's called a conjunction. You mentioned full moon. Well, a full moon is when the sun and moon are on opposite sides of each other on that circle. You might have one planet at 12 o'clock and another planet at 3 o'clock. That's a square, 90 degrees. It all breaks down to very simple observations, and each one of those has a meaning. And sometimes it can get downright scary when you think about how those alignments can show us what's going on in our lives and the world around us.
Yes, and that is what the Sky Vibe is about. We're going to break down things for you to understand you yourself better through the tools of astrology, which I'm really excited about, Thomas, because I've seen it come to fruition in my own life over and over and over again.
Yeah, you've used it a lot in observing about your relationships.
Yes, and when you did my chart, everything seemed to make sense as to why I was... Oh, that's why I'm always picking the certain man that I'm picking. The tendencies that I had. And yes, I am a full-on sun Leo. But when you have a Scorpio rising and then a Pisces moon, that's where all the other stuff came in. So it was not one aha moment, because I've always read a lot about astrology. It was more of, oh, it makes sense. Everything's starting to click. And I've been using it to be able to see things a little more clearly in my own life, to know why I'm doing the things that I'm doing. And to, when I need the scorpionic energy, my ascending, how to use it. Or when you do these daily podcasts of where the sun, the moon, the stars, the planets, all that other stuff, if I'm saying it right, where everything is and how it's placed in my own chart, I know. If I'm going to react a certain way, okay, that's my Scorpio rising act. I gotta bring it back. Or when Mercury's in retrograde, take 10 seconds. Don't send that text right away. My impulsive Leo wants to send it because doesn't he love me? I'm the best there is, you know, kind of a thing.
Exactly.
And I go, wait, Mercury going to be taken the wrong way.
Exactly.
So the tools.
You know, it is an amazing guide. And I'll tell you, here's what I've been reflecting on lately. I met astrology when I was at a low point in my life. The year was 2009, and I had just gone through a second divorce. And the way I grew up in Tulsa, Oklahoma, in fact, which you're in St. Louis, Tulsa was the farm club to the Cardinals back when I was growing up. And St. Louis to me was like, oh, that's the big town. You know, that's where you go if you really need something. And that's certainly where you go listen to Jack Buck and Harry Carey doing the Cardinals games back in the 1970s. Now that's,
wow,
there's some nostalgia for you. But my upbringing was on the fundamental side and astrology was shunned. I mean, it was of the devil. Well, mm-hmm. if we're going to go down that route, how did all those planets end up on that great big circle in that alignment? It takes a lot less faith to believe that that was created by God than it just randomly happened from some big explosion. Mm-hmm. I mean, I definitely think that there was design in the whole thing. It's absolutely beautiful. So yeah. once I hit that low point, I kind of wiped everything off to a blank slate of belief. And I'm like, I have got to reconstruct a belief system that works for me because I was not supposed to get divorced once coming from, you know, fundamental upbringing, wonderful little family. But I just all of a sudden had to stop and look at why did my life turn out the way it did? And what I realized is I was not living consciously. I was not living intentionally. Mm-hmm. And one of the things I took a look at was astrology. And the very first, all I knew about it was that I was a Scorpio. That's all I knew. And I just took a look at it and read some things on my sun sign. And I was like, wow, that's totally me. Or mm-hmm. good chunk of it. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to know more. And the more I studied, the more I learned, the more I got into it, the more I realized that this was the design system. This is the operating system code, if you will, for living a conscious life.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that astrology is going to make something happen to you. It's not that you're looking into evil places for answers to your life and that all of a sudden, you know, the Grim Reaper is going to jump out of a closet at you. It's not that at all. Mm-hmm. It has such a, I mean, the interpretations around it are so lunatic crazy that even the very people who throw the biggest rocks at astrology have in the manger scene of the Bible, the three magi, which are now translated as wise men. Why did they call them wise men back then? Well, that's the magi society still exists today. They were Persian astrologers.
Magi, magic. Just and take the C off.
What did they say? We saw his star in the east and we have come to worship him. Where is he?
And didn't Jesus say, look to the stars for signs? Look
in
to the
Luke,
sky for signs?
Yes, in the book of Luke. And many references in both the Old and New Testaments to the sky and the design of the sky to give us guidance and to give us leading. Mm-hmm. So in used in proper ways, it is the ultimate tool for conscious living. So we can look to these things that astrology gives us and how it unpacks these things. And then we can decide from that where the energy is flowing and how we're going to relate to it. So you think of like a surfer. I used to live on the beach in Florida for about a year. And boy, whenever the forecast was just so, you knew the surfers were going to be out the next day. It wasn't the nicest day, but boy, the surfers absolutely loved it. Well, they were looking at the signs. They knew what the forecast was. They knew where the energy was. The wind is going to blow. And they wanted to be out there in the middle of it. And that's how you can use astrology to literally catch a wave of energy in your life and ride that to a conscious outcome.
Beautiful analogy, Thomas. Beautiful analogy. Welcome to the Sky Vibe. Thank you for joining us. Just you wait.
We have a lot more to come for sure. And if you'd like to check out my daily podcast where we just take a look at this in the mornings really quickly, like 5-6 minutes, come to funastrology.com. New episodes come out Monday through Saturday at 3 a.m. And we'd love to see you over there too.